Mary Mary Beach here. It's March, and this is the second time I'm looking for beehives. And right now, I'm checking on one of the breeder queens that I have. Very expensive queen, and I want to see if she's still alive. I usually keep the breeder queen hives a little small, but winterizing them needs to be strong enough to survive. So, look at this. I'm not stimulating the breeder queens. So I see cap brood and open larvae, open brood and eggs. So Her Majesty is supposed to be somewhere here. A lot of pollen, bee bread. The center of the nest. I'm talking to them, I'm going to be gentle. Cap brood, open brood, eggs. And here she is, right here. Number 44. She's a good queen. And let's look at this one too. Cap brood, open brood, eggs. I don't know if you can see her. Okay. So it's in good condition. I keep the breeder queens in small colonies for to be sure they have no desire to swarm on me. And second is it to find them when you need to find them. And third, the egg quality. So that's very important. It's one thing when they lay 2,000 eggs a day. Another thing is when they lay 200 different quality, and they are not that way. You can have them lasting longer, because those are expensive queens. I like this insulation. Winter time is just fantastic. There is no condensation on the nest itself. If there is any condensation, it's going to be on the walls of the beehive, and mostly on the front, because during the winter I bunch them together and then put queen barrier around and then put a tarp over.